Sometimes in a project, you'll find that you need to find distance, and one of the easiest ways to do that is with a cheap ultrasonic sensor like this. These work by sending ultrasonic sound waves out and measuring how long it takes for it to reflect back. In this video, we're going to look at how to use it with a Raspberry Pi Pico, what the working principle is, how to connect it to the Pico, and the code you need on the Pico to use it. So how does one of these ultrasonic sensors actually work? Looking at the data sheet, we can see that it has four pins, the VCC and ground. This gets connected to 5 volt. It has to be an external 5 volt source because the Pico is only 3.3 volts and ground. Then there's the trig pin and the echo pin. What the trig pin does is it accepts a signal from the microcontroller saying send out those ultrasonic waves. And the echo pin is high for as long as those ultrasonic waves take to return. If we take a look at the timing diagram, it gives a little clearer explanation. So you set the trig pin high for 10 microseconds, then the ultrasonic sensor sends out the 8 sonic bursts, and then the echo pin is high for as long as it takes for those sonic bursts to come back. And we can find how long that is in centimeters with this very simple formula of the microseconds the echo pin is high divided by 58 for centimeters, or divided by 148 for inches. So let's look at how you connect the ultrasonic sensor here to the Raspberry Pi Pico. The ground pin goes to the ground. The VCC has to go to an external 5-volt power supply. I have it here. These will be connected to my bench power supply. Then the trig pin can go directly to any GPIO pin. So it's just going into pin 2 for me here. But the echo pin, because this is a 5-volt device and the Pico is a 3.3-volt device, if you put the echo pin directly into a GPIO pin of the Raspberry Pi Pico, there's a good chance you'll break it. So what you need to do is add these two resistors right here as a voltage divider. And what that does is it steps down the 5 volts from the echo pin of the ultrasonic sensor to a 3.3 volt that the Raspberry Pi Pico can handle. The voltage divider here consists of a 2.2 kiloohm resistor and a 3.3 kiloohm resistor. So now we have the ultrasonic sensor connected to the Raspberry Pi Pico. Let's look at the code that interacts with the ultrasonic directly and how you can use that code in your own projects. So the code that interacts with the ultrasonic sensor directly is in this script called ultrasonic.c. And there are four functions. The first one you need to call is setup ultrasonic pins. This takes what pin the trig is and which pin the echo pin is connected to. It initializes them and then sets the direction so that the trig pin is an out pin and the echo pin is an in pin. Then there are two other ones that you'll interface with. This is get centimeter and get inch. And both of these use the get pulse function to get the pulse and then return based on just a little bit of division. The get pulse one works by sending out the 10 microsecond pulse to the ultrasonic sensor and then waiting for the echo pin to go high, then timing how many microseconds the echo pin is high and returning that amount of time. Then using that script in your own projects is as simple as defining the trigger and echo pin, setting up those pins with the setup ultrasonic pins function, and then using either get centimeters or get inch and handing that the trigger pin and echo pin, and it just returns you an integer value with the amount of centimeters or the amount of inches. And in this example, I have it set that it'll print out the centimeters every 10,000 microseconds using printf. If you don't know how USB serial works, check out my video of it in the corner right now. So right here I have the ultrasonic sensor connected to the Pico in our setup, and in the terminal window you're seeing, that is the live output from the Pico. And it's just displaying the amount of centimeters that it's recording from the ultrasonic sensor. So if I take this foot-long ruler, that's about 30 centimeters, and hold it right about at top, you can see it reads back 30 centimeters. If I go to the middle, it should be 15. If I go down some, 10, 20. So you can see that the ultrasonic sensor is reading the correct centimeter value from how far away it is. I've also included a C++ wrapper for this library, so you can use it like an object. So in this example, the object example, you can see you create an object called ultrasonic, My Ultrasonic, and when you're creating this object, you define the trig and echo pins. Then, whenever you want to get the centimeters or inches in the future, use My Ultrasonic, or whatever you end up calling it, dot get centimeter or get inch. All the code we saw in this video today will be linked in a GitHub page below. If you like this video, be sure to hit the like button. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and be sure to subscribe because I have a few more Pico tutorials coming out, a really cool robot build, and lots of animatronics in the future.